How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to show you guys three of the best VPNs for Long Beach, California, and just California in general. Now, before we begin, if you guys are interested in links to pricing and discounts, you'll find everything you need in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs. Okay, so with ExpressVPN, NordVPN, and Surfshark, they're all really good VPNs, obviously, when it comes to just generally bypassing geo-restrictions and securing your connection. Now, downloading a VPN is the smart way to stay connected and protected in California, no matter what network you're connected to. Of course, especially when using public Wi-Fi, you should have a VPN that protects your financial information or any kind of sensitive information that you might be having on your mobile device or laptop for that matter. Now, besides many of the public Wi-Fis, there are obviously various music festivals held in California. Most notably, Coachella offer pop-up Wi-Fi connections, but they are intermittent, overloaded, and unsafe. So downloading a VPN can bypass all of these issues and let you focus on enjoying yourself. There are plenty of other benefits to using a VPN, obviously, and some of the benefits may include seamless connection across all the serviced locations, additional protection from cyber attacks, access to international libraries on Netflix and other major streaming platforms, reliable connection strength and speed, user-friendly apps, and customer support. All these VPNs do offer that, IP address protection and privacy, encrypted networks to protect against hackers, and being able to stream events from certain locations that are inaccessible elsewhere. All right, and just one thing to note to the untrained eye, these VPNs may seem a little bit more complicated than they look, but it really is as simple as just clicking a button and you are good to go. And I'll go ahead and bring up my IP address finder. You can use any IP address finder and you'll notice that it'll show as if I am in Tampa, even though I am not in Tampa. So let's bring it over here real quick. And there it is, Tampa, Florida. Now, if you're looking for, well, California servers, of course, you're going to find that across all of these VPNs, though some VPNs may have some servers or locations that other VPNs may not have. So, for example, here in ExpressVPN, let's say you're looking for California servers, you're going to find, generally quite a bit of West Coast servers. So San Francisco, LA, quite a few LA locations. These are locations, not servers, by the way. And you have, I believe, Santa Monica right here. All right. So with NordVPN, you'll notice that we have, well, now that's Seattle. So we have San Francisco and LA, no Santa Monica, but I believe we do have a Santa Monica server in Surfshark, just like ExpressVPN. So LA, Vegas, San Francisco, and I believe that would be it for West Coast servers, specifically California servers. So that would be it, really. And obviously, when it comes to using the VPN, it really is as simple as just clicking one of these servers and you are good to go. Okay, so how do you know which one of these VPNs could be the best choice for you? Well, it depends on what you're looking for out of the VPN. Now, ExpressVPN has over 3,000 servers in 94 countries and will allow you to secure up to 5 devices per subscription. ExpressVPN has basic features such as the internet kill switch, which is called network lock in Express, and split tunneling. Now, if you're not familiar with these, the kill switch will make sure that you're only connected to the internet when you're secured by the VPN. So if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly, it will also disconnect your internet connection, making sure that you don't connect back to the ISP servers, making sure that you don't connect back to your internet service provider's servers, and only be connected through the VPN secured servers. Now, split tunneling will allow you to choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not. So you could only have, for example, your torrenting client routed through the VPN while the rest of your network is left intact or untouched by the VPN connection. Or the other way around, where you could have select applications bypass the VPN connection, while the rest of your network is secured by the VPN. Okay, so let's say you're looking for a VPN that is a little bit more budget-friendly, and that would be NordVPN with over 5,100 servers in 60 countries. Now, even though NordVPN has 34 less countries than ExpressVPN, as you can tell, it is still quite the number at 60 countries. You'll be able to secure up to 6 devices per subscription, though, and a whole bunch of security features such as specialty servers, as you can tell here, with a dedicated IP, double VPN, onion over VPN, and peer-to-peer, and of course, you've got an ad blocker right here and the very quick and best performing protocol, NordLynx. Keep in mind, when you switch to NordLynx, you will lose access to double VPN and dedicated IP. And unless you need these specific specialty servers, I would just recommend that you stick to NordLynx, which is a very quick protocol. In fact, so quick that you don't want to use anything else. Not only do you get the conventional kill switch, but you also get the app kill switch, which will close selected apps when you disconnect from the VPN or the connection drops, rather than disconnecting your entire connection as it is with the conventional kill switch. Split tunneling. You've got also custom DNS, which is an easy way to change your DNS, and obfuscated servers if you're in a censorship heavy country. Now, if you're looking for the most budget-friendly VPN, that would be Surfshark. Surfshark has over 3,200 servers in 65 countries, which makes it a very convenient option for those wanting to secure a whole bunch of devices with just one subscription, because it will allow you to virtually secure an unlimited number of devices with just one subscription. And it being such a budget-friendly VPN, without necessarily sacrificing much on security, performance, or features for that matter, makes it a very enticing VPN for most people, especially those that don't want to spend a whole lot, at least on their first VPN experience. So you still get multi-hop and static IP, which are the same as double VPN and dedicated IP from NordVPN. And if you don't know what these are, by the way, static IP will give you, well, static IP addresses, which means that these servers have IPs that are set and do not change. Multi-hop will route your connection through two servers, as you can tell, rather than one, for double the protection, making it extra difficult to track you. And in these settings here, you will notice that we still get whitelister, which is split tunneling, it's just called whitelister here, the kill switch, an ad blocker, as well as a handful of protocols. For the most part, you just want to use the best performing protocol. Again, that'll be the WireGuard protocol. It's so quick that you don't want to use anything else. You've got IKEV2, which is a good protocol. It's pretty quick. Extra security will be offered by OpenVPN, both UDP and TCP, and Shadow Socks will help you reach banned websites if you're in a censorship-heavy country, though it will only secure your browser traffic, so keep that in mind. And No Borders Mode will help you bypass the Great Firewall of China if you are in China or any other censorship-heavy country, for that matter. And, you know, if you notice that ExpressVPN doesn't really have any obfuscated kind of options here for obfuscation and whatnot, that's because ExpressVPN actually has obfuscation on by default. It's always on, and you don't have to go through any sort of configuration or toggle any kind of option in order to turn it on. All you have to do is download it, and it will work whether you're in China, outside of China, in any other censorship heavy country. It doesn't matter. That's, of course, part of the ease of use with ExpressVPN. So that'll be it for this video, guys. Keep in mind that all these VPNs are covered by a 30-day money-back guarantee. So no matter which VPN you decide to go for, you'll be able to claim the refund. Let me just show you guys very quickly. So if I go ahead and get ExpressVPN, you'll notice that all these VPNs, it says there are 30-day money-back guarantees on them. So even if you just go for the one-month plan, you will be able to claim the refund through the 24/7 live chat support. By the way, it's the same with NordVPN and Surfshark. All you need to do is hover over the bottom right, and you'll be able to access the live chat support, the 24/7 live chat support, where they will help you with your refund or any other question you might be having about these VPNs. Again, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below for all of these VPNs, and you'll also find full reviews that'll give you more of an in-depth look into the privacy policy, speed streaming, and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. So be sure to check those out if you guys are interested. That'll be it for this video. Comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.